In the name of Allah, the Rahman and the Rahim. Dear viewers, Assalamu alaikum. It's semantics class. Today we are taking second lecture on lexical relations. We have studied lexical relations. The first one, like we have five lexical relations as a whole. So first of all, I'll give the outline of the lecture. We will introduce the topic and then I'll define that what is lexical relation. Then we will discuss five types of lexical relations. These are synonymy, hyponymy, antonymy, polysemy and homonymy with examples. Dear students, as we know that words play different roles in a sentence, in a language. In a language organization, in a language like in a structure, we have different roles of words. Likewise, words having various features, like we have discussed semantic feature of words. They have also relationship with other words, like words cannot always used in isolation. But we are using words in like in the group of other words, in the company of other words. Like words have specific requirements and they always having specific environment. So in this environment we are using words, then we are like taking meaning of those words. So now, the definition of lexical relation. Lexical relation, according to dictionary, lexical relations are the relationship between meaning of words. So, the relation between meaning of words or among meaning of words is called lexical relation. According to Bollinger or Bollinger, it's a French word. In 1968, he defines or he stated that lexical relations are the relationship of the meaning of a word to other words. Like words, relations with other words, this relation is known as lexical relation. According to Yule, according to George Yule, he also states that the relationship between two or more words is called lexical relations, like in which the meaning of the word in term of relationship to like one word meaning or two word meaning in terms of relation or more words to each other is the analysis of lexical relation. Yes, when we are like trying to know the meaning of one word, we are making relation of that word with other words. So this process is called, this like activity is called lexical relation, the analysis of lexical relation. Like when we are analyzing words, when we are trying to know the meaning of words, so then we are referring to other words for the sake of understanding the meaning of one word, okay? For further information, you can see, you can also visit the book The Study of Language by George Yule in detail, like detailed description is given by him in this book. Now, types of lexical relations. There are five types of lexical relations. This idea is given by Palmer in 1976. Okay, so these five types are synonymy, hyponymy, antonymy, polysemy, and homonymy. So these, remember students, this is according to Palmer, okay, in 1976 he has given. Other like types of relations are there in semantics, in linguistic semantics, okay. So like homophones, this is also one of the relations. Other like collocation, wordplay, okay. Prototypes, these all are like the relations, lexical relations, they are also counted in lexical relations. But these five are very famous and these are given by Palmer. Synonymy, we have discussed in our earlier lecture in detail that synonymy is sameness of meaning, which is not related to the conceptual meaning of words. Like we have conceptual meaning of words. Conceptually, words are very, very much different. Like meaning-wise, they are different when we are analyzing conceptual meanings. But this relation is like sameness is meaning is there in synonymy. But relations of words which have the same conceptual meaning, synonymous is words that have the same conceptual meaning like elevator and lift, gala, like sport galas, like we have festivity. We have discussed, you should watch the earlier lecture, okay? If you have any problem, you can ask me. Now, in today's discussion, this is very much special that the focus is on the on the remaining four, okay? Hyponymy. Hyponymy involves the notion of inclusion. Yes, the concept of inclusion is involved in hyponymy. When the meaning of one form, like the definition of hyponymy is, when the meaning of one form is included in the meaning of another, like when the meaning of one word is included in the meaning of another, or the meaning of one term, when it is included in another term, so this is called hyponymy relations, okay, of words, among words or between words. We have like different examples of are there, okay. So the meaning of rose is included in flower. The meaning of lion in elephant is included in mammal or animal, okay, they are animal. So hyponymy is the term which is referred to a set or a group of words that are included in a higher term or word. Like animal, okay? Animal, in animal we have dog, we have horse, we have snake. Again in dog we have poodle, and again in snake we have other types. So the meaning of dog, the meaning of horse, the meaning of snake, these meanings, these words, these noun meanings are included in the meaning of animal. So the word animal and like they have a hyponymy relation. So we can say that the word dog is the hyponym of the word animal, okay? And a word horse is also a hyponym of the word animal. So these all are like they are sharing a relation which is hyponymous, okay? Hyponymy relations. So there is difference, dear students. It's very important. The higher are the upper term, like in case of animal, animal is the higher term. The higher or upper term or word is called a superordinate, okay? Superordinate. And the lower term is called a hyponym or co-hyponym, okay? So the first, like the animal is the higher term, which is called superordinate. And the meaning of dog, horse and snake, these meanings are included in the meaning of animal. So the word animal is superordinate, which is a higher term, and these three occur under the umbrella of that higher term. So they are co-hyponym, or they are called hyponym, okay? Lines in 1963 observed that in classical Greek, there is a superordinate term to cover a variety of professions and crafts such as carpenter, doctor, flute player, helmsman and shoemaker. The nearest possible term is the craftsman. Like the meaning of one, like in Greek, okay? So these all are the name of profession. So the word profession includes these all terms. Some other examples of hyponymy are, like, we have vegetable, and in vegetable we have carrots, we have cabbage, we have spinach, we have lettuce. So these, like the meaning of carrot, the meaning of cabbage in Spanish, these meanings are included in the meaning of vegetable. So the word vegetable is subordinate term, and the remaining four are co-heponym of that very superordinate term. Like, we have another example, bird, swallow, okay, and cranny, crane, canary, woodpecker, quail. These all are small birds or large birds, but the meaning of these are included in the word bird. So a word, the word bird is a superordinate term. In these, the remaining four or five are like the co-heponym of the word bird. So dear students, another relationship we have now able to define, hyponymy. Hyponymy is the relation when the meaning of one form is included in the meaning of others. So this relationship is known as hyponymy relation. Now we have antonymy. Very simple. It is the very opposite of the synonymy. Antonymy is oppositeness of the meanings. Like in synonymy is the sameness of meanings, okay? And antonymy is the relation of the opposition in meanings. So antonymy is oppositeness of the meaning. Antonymy also relates to word meaning, like synonymy. Yes, these are like synonymy, antonymy, and others. Hyponymy, these all forms, are these all relation help us in getting vocabulary and understanding many words meanings. It is also called a sense relation. According to Palmer, he divides three kinds of antonymy. Like, for example, the first one is gradable antonymy, complementarity, yes, and relational oppositeness. Mainly two are discussed, like according to Palmer, there are three further types of antonymy, but mainly there are two types, okay? Gradable antonymy or non-gradable antonymy, and non-gradable are also called complementarity, okay? Gradable antonymy means when we are like the oppositeness in meanings along with scale, okay, along with scale. Like in gradable antonymy, the meaning of each word is relative, that it can be put in graded scale, which is not fixed. We are using gradable antonymy when we are making comparison between two things or two people. For example, the gradable antonymy narrow, wide. Like, this street is very narrow than that one. Your street is very narrow than mine street, okay? Young and old. I'm young than that very old person. Small and big. When we are making comparison between things, like gradable antonymy means these are like comparative adjectives, you can say. Okay, they are always comparative adjectives. Antonymic complementarity. In antonymic complementarity, the meaning of the word is absolute, not relative. That is just one possibility of meaning, which is fixed. For example, male and female, like we have direct comparison, when we have direct oppositeness in meanings, so then we are calling that antonymy complementarity or complementary, like female and male. These are directly opposite to one another. Single, married, dead, alive, open, closed, empty, full, up, down, right, left. In rational opposites, the pair of words are the reversal of a relationship of two words. Yes, so the third one, rational opposites. By sell, lent, barrow. Like these complementarity antonymy is related to nouns, and the first one, which is gradable antonymy, these are related to adjectives, okay? And the third one, these are related to rational, like the relations of words among the meanings, among the concepts. Another relation, polysemy. Polysemy is the term that refers to a word that has a set of different meanings which are related. Like one word having different meanings. When one word, one form of word having same structure, but having different meanings, okay? So this is called polysemy, like sit, okay, bake. Bake means bake of human. Polysemy means when one form, written or spoken, having multiple meanings that are related by extension, okay? Like we have word bake. A set of different meanings are there related to the word bake. Human bake, the bake of a chair, the bake of a sofa, the bake of the hand. So these all are the polysemy. One word carries different meaning, different set of meanings. Like we have word eye, human eye, okay? The eye of a needle, the eye of a potato, a hook and an eye. Another example, foot, human foot, okay? The foot of a bed, the foot of a hill, the foot of a mountain. So many examples are there with this concept, polysemy. Polysemy basically means that when one form, written or spoken, having multiple meanings. So this is called polysemy, okay? Another we have homonymy. Homonymy is the term that refers to one form, which is the same in both in written as well as in spoken, with two or more unrelated meanings, according to Jarjeul. Like homonymy means when, like same form, same structure, same word, spoken or in written, like same pronunciation, same spelling, and same structure in spoken or in written, but having two or more unrelated meaning, like bank. So we have the bank of a river and bank of a financial institution. So spelling is same, pronunciation is same, and having different meanings, two different meanings, bank of a river and bank of a financial institution. But it belongs to context. Remember students, it depends on context. When we are nearer to river, okay, when we are like in jungle, so when we are in like in a position where river is near, so then we are seeing that when you are telling somebody on your mobile phone that I am nearer to the bank of a river. When you are in the city, So then we are saying, then you will be telling that I am in financial institution, or I am waiting you near to the financial institution. People means students, and also we have people in the I. Mole, an animal, are like mole means, like mole has two different meanings. An animal are a small dog. Again, mark. Mark is a word like mark on the skin, and a stone wall built in the sea is also called mark. Sole, the sole of a shoe, or the sole of a fish. Leaf, we have word leaf, very known example, leaf of a tree and leaf of a book. So same spelling, same word, same structure, spoken or written, having two or more meanings, unrelated meanings, like leaf of a tree and leaf of a book, unrelated meaning. Bill, a bird's bill, a bird's or mouth, okay? A bird's mouth, or a statement of charges. Proposed law, okay? A bank note. File, holder for keeping papers, a line of person or things, okay? File. Example, other examples are there. Dear students, I hope you will be enjoying and understanding this lecture. Now I'll give you the summary that what we have discussed so far in this lecture. Dear students, as we know that two or more words with very closely related meanings are called synonymous. Okay, they are like this relationship is called synonymy. Two or more words with closely related meaning, always, often but not always. We have examples like reply and answer, okay, like couch and sofa. So these are synonymous, okay? Two forms with opposite meanings are called antonymous or antonymy relation, like rich and poor, dead and alive, okay? Small and short, big and another like small, okay? Huge, small. So we have different examples for like synonymous is sameness in meanings, and antonymy is oppositeness in meanings. When the meaning of one form is included in the other form, this relationship is called hyponymy. And hyponymy, we have two types, superordinate term, and another is cohyponym, or the having hyponym and superordinate terms in hyponymy. Polysemy means when we encounter two or more words with the same form and related meanings. This is called hyponymy. And we have homonym. Okay, when one form written or spoken has two or more unrelated meanings. This is called homonymy. Okay, the last one. Dear students, having any question you can ask, please, you should ask questions, you should comment. Best of luck. Thanks for watching and giving time to us. Assalamu alaikum.